So, you know, we get this question a lot, and, you know, how should I as a patient manage my diet with lupus? And I think it's a great question. I think it's an extremely important question. You know, if we can modify our own risk factors in terms of preventing disease or preventing worsening or flare-ups of our disease, that would be amazing. And that's really what's driven me to look into this area as an area of research. How can we modify our own risk? Unfortunately, though, as I've mentioned, there really hasn't been any sort of definitive answers in terms of what the role of diet is in preventing lupus or even causing lupus or preventing its worsening. So I will say, you know, this is just a picture of, like, if you Google lupus and diet, you know, many, many, many theories and books and, you know, lectures and articles pop up on what you should eat and what you shouldn't eat. And I just want to mention that we really should be aware of misinformation because, you know, I've seen it before and I've heard of patients, you know, really sort of going to extremes in their diet, dietary changes because of some of the information that's out there. And we just want to make sure that, you know, any dietary changes that you make should really not delay any necessary treatments that are being recommended by your physician. I cannot emphasize that enough. And, you know, it should be, if there are dietary changes, it should be discussed with your physician, your nutritionist, your team, so that, you know, there's an understanding of what's being done. And you know, those individuals can also weigh in. So I thought we would just, you know, briefly mention how I approach this conversation with patients and how I think about it. You know, and I think it's important to first look at your own sort of health picture as an individual. It's important to examine underlying nutritional deficiencies and replete those as needed, because that can, you know, these can often coincide with chronic diseases. Medications definitely can play a role here. And, you know, steroids, for example, corticosteroids like prednisone and Medrol and others that we use to manage our disease can certainly contribute to diabetes and osteoporosis, and the role of diet and exercise cannot be overemphasized in trying to help ward off some of these factors as well. Your life stage, you know, the dietary recommendations might be different for women who are childbearing, those who are postmenopausal, so it is important to consider these as well. Physical activity, you know, as well, can be extremely important in managing one's disease and feeling well. And then smoking, as I mentioned, smoking has been one of the major environmental risk factors that's been demonstrated repeatedly in a number of epidemiologic studies as potentially being associated with our rheumatic diseases, including lupus. You should also consider your risk for other common comorbidities of lupus. You know, cardiovascular disease is highly associated with lupus. It's one of the leading causes of death in lupus. And so, you know, tailoring one's diet to preventing cardiovascular disease and having a heart-healthy diet is key. Similarly, high blood pressure, kidney disease, you know, as we know, and diabetes and osteoporosis are also associated with either the disease or sometimes the treatments that we use to get the disease under control. You know, and as I mentioned, there are, you know, lupus patients may be at increased risk of cardiovascular disease and cardiovascular death. So it's important to manage that component when thinking about diet and exercise as well. So in terms of just how to think about this in terms of granularly, you know, I think we really sort of use the guidelines, the dietary guidelines that are published when I recommend how to optimize their health and including their comorbidities. And I think it's important to consider, you know, a patient's culture, their preferences, various food sensitivities that they might have, even though food sensitivities haven't really been shown to be clearly associated with lupus in particular, and also the budget, you know, and that's an extremely important factor. So, you know, the current guidelines that have been published this year, listed below, really emphasize eating more fruits and vegetables, whole grains, legumes, and nuts, which, as I mentioned, may potentially be associated with lupus, preventing lupus, seafood, other kinds of, you know, healthier meats, unsaturated oils, and low or non-fat dairy. So, you know, while there's not clear evidence, these items are thought to, you know, be heart healthy and to optimize one's overall health. The foods that have been de-emphasized overall are red and processed meats, sugar-sweetened beverages, which I mentioned has been significantly associated with an increased risk of rheumatoid arthritis, saturated fats, refined grains, and high sodium foods. So this is sort of a summary slide on how one can sort of optimize one's health in the constraints of having the diagnosis and the medications that we use, and in taking into consideration the comorbidities that can develop with lupus.